Hey everyone! Today we'll show you how to create a stylish intro with your channel title. Let's jump right into it. First things first, use the text icon from the left-hand side menu to add a text object to the scene. Adjust its size and letter thickness using the text editor at the top. Next, we need to create framing. To do that, add a rectangle to the scene. And apply style number 2 from the menu, borderline only. Change the borderline color to white and adjust its thickness using the right-hand side menu. Highlight both objects, the text and the rectangle in the scene, make a right mouse button click and convert them to sprite. Now you have a sprite on the timeline. Go ahead and adjust its parameters. First of all, find the sprite object settings and select No in the Use as Container field. In the field below named Show Effects, switch to Yes. Finally, turn off the background by switching to No in the Fill Background field. Awesome! Our sprite is ready. Here, we'll be applying the effects. First, add the Fade In effect to make your title appearance a bit smoother. Place the cursor at the end of the fade-in effect and align the rectangle object with the cursor. In other words, the ending of the fade-in effect should coincide with the beginning of the rectangle object on the timeline. Now we will apply effects to the rectangle object and add dynamics to its appearance. To start, make a double click on it. Go to the Video Effects tab, proceed to Transition and select Wipe. In the Properties window on the right-hand side, find Transition Levels and set the value at 100, 0. Go back to the Sprite tab. Open the Video Effects tab again and find Fade Out. Place the effect at the end of the sprite. The next step will be to edit the background. Go to the very first tab on the timeline and add a video using the corresponding button or by dragging it to the scene. Adjust video duration to make it equal to the duration of sprite and place it one layer below. Now we are going to apply movement to the text. First, move the sprite object to the level below the video. Make a double click on it and add movement using the corresponding icon from the menu on the left-hand side. Place the movement arrow right in the center of the video and drag the yellow handle to the end of the fade-in effect. If you want to add even more style, you can apply Gaussian blur to the background video. It's located in the Video Effects tab under the Filters section. There you have it, guys. A stylish, professional-looking intro for your channel videos created at zero cost. You probably can't wait to try it yourself. Let us know how it goes in the comments below. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up so that we know that you liked it. Until next time!